Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dear students, in last lesson we have studied the reproduction. Reproduction is the process of production of new individual with some similarities from their parents at the same time with several differences. Okay? So we know that in asexual reproduction, the individuals which are formed by asexual reproduction, they exhibit minor variations, whereas the individuals which are produced from the sexual reproduction, they exhibit more variations. And that mechanism also we have studied, that why these variations, minor and major variations, are occurred in asexual and sexual reproduction. Now in this lesson we shall deal with the mechanism by which these variations are created, and that variations are passed on from one generation to another. Okay, now we'll see first about the heredity. So this heredity you have already studied in the 9th standard, correct, in the lesson heredity and variation. So in this heredity, it is the transmission of trait. It is the transmission of traits. Which traits? Physical or mental. Okay, transmission of trait, physical or mental, from their parents to the offsprings, means from parents to their offsprings, is only called as heredity. So heredity, it is the transmission of trait, physical or mental, from parents to their offsprings. Understood? Here many scientists were curious to know about this heredity process and to know about the mechanism by which these variations are occurred, and that variations are passed on from one generation to another. Okay, and this Gregor John Mendel, he is the first. Gregor John Mendel, Mendel's experiment you have already studied in 9th standard, monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. So this Gregor John Mendel, he is pioneer of modern genetic. Who is he? He is a pioneer of modern genetic. Okay, modern genetics. So why he is called as pioneer of modern genetics? Because here this Gregor John Mendel first time predict that inside of the cell of every individual, means inside the cell of every individual, there is a something, or there is one factor which is only responsible for the transmission of traits from one generation to another, and he named that time that factor as a gene. What he named that factor? He named that factor as a gene, and he predict as well as he named that factor as a gene even before the discovery of the microscope. And that's why this Gregor John Mendel, because of his work, he is called as pioneer of the modern genetic. Okay, so who is the pioneer of modern genetics? He is Gregor John Mendel. And why he is called as pioneer of modern genetics? Because very first time, means first time, he only predict that there is something inside of cell of every individual, and that factor which is present inside of the cell is only responsible for the transmission of trait from one generation to another. And that time he named that factor as a gene even before the discovery of microscope. Understood? Then see, next one. In 1901, what happened? One of the mutational theory of Hugo de Ries. See the spelling, Hugo de Ries, V-R-I-E-S. Okay. So see, in the year 1901, mutational theory of Hugo de Riis means mutational theory. It was proposed by Hugo de Riis, and because of that theory, we came to know about the reason of the sudden change which are occurred. Okay, so why this sudden change are occurred? We understood the reason behind that sudden change because of only this theory, and that is called as mutational theory, which was given or which was proposed by Hugo de Riis. Okay, so this Gregor John Mendel, he took long time to draw the conclusion by taking many experiments. We know that he took many experiments on the pea plant. So this Gregor John Mendel, he took long time to draw his conclusion in his research, but finally he came to know that the factor only responsible for transmission of the trait. So after that, in 1901, a mutational theory was proposed by Hugo de Riis, and because of that theory we came to know, or we start to know about the reasons which are behind the sudden change. Okay, then in 1902 what happened? See, Walter Sutton, he first time observed a paired chromosomes inside the cells of grasshopper. Paired chromosomes, we know that chromosomes are always present in a pair, and it was first time noticed by whom? He is a Walter Sutton. So in the year 1902, Walter Sutton first time noticed that inside of the cells of the grasshopper, means inside the cells only, first time he noticed inside the cells of the grasshopper that the chromosomes are present in a pair. Okay, so in 1902, Walter Sutton first time observed a pair chromosome inside the cells of the grasshopper, and before him it was not observed by anyone, means before him it was not observed by any scientist. So he is only the first time observed that the chromosomes are present in a pair, and he observed that pair chromosome inside of the grasshopper, and it was happened in the year 1902. Okay, in the year 1944, a trio of scientists, it is a team or group of three scientists, and that's why it is called as a trio of scientists. So in this team of the scientists, three scientists were there. That three scientists are Oswald Avery, MacLean McCarthy, and Colin MacLeod. Okay. So in this team, see, trios of the scientists, three scientists were worked together. That scientist names are Oswald Avery, MacLean McCarthy, and the third one is Colin MacLeod. So these three scientists together, what they proved there? They proved that except viruses, every individual has DNA as a genetical material. Means DNA, it is the genetical material for every individual except viruses, and it was proved by trios of the scientists in the year 1944. So with that scientists are Oswald Avery, MacLean McCarthy, and Colin MacLeod. Okay. In the year 1961, two French geneticists They propose one model of protein synthesis, and the names of that geneticist are Francois Jacob and Jack Monod. Okay, Jack Monod it is corrected, huh? So two French geneticists are Francois Jacob and the Jack Monod. These two French geneticists proposed a model of protein synthesis. So that model which was proposed by them, they are useful to us to uncover the genetical code which are hidden inside of the DNA. So what is the use of that model? That model of protein synthesis. It was proposed by two geneticists, Francois Jacob and the Jack Monod, and it is now became useful to us to uncover or to predict, we can say, or to detect the genetical code which is hidden inside of the DNA. So we know that inside of the DNA there is one particular genetical code which is responsible for that particular characteristics and which is passed on from one generation to another, and because of this model only now it became possible to uncover or to detect, we can say, to detect that genetical code which is hidden inside of the DNA. So in this way here different scientists work together on the heredity concept, and we know that the science of heredity, it is useful. We have already seen in the 9th standard that there are some hereditary disorders, and that prediction of, or we can say the detection, at the same time diagnosis and the treatment of that hereditary disorders are now became possible only because of this science of the heredity. Okay, at the same time this science of the heredity, it is also useful for the production of hybrid varieties of the plants and the animals, and this heredity, that is science of heredity, it is also useful in industrial processes. In that we know that in industries many microbes are used, so where the microbes are used in the industries, in that industries also this science of heredity is